Hi everyone, I'm Yukta Mohta, a high school senior in Lagos, Nigeria. I'm a member of the Lagos Interact Club and I'm your host on the Canary for this week. Let's begin by giving a countdown of the articles that have been published this week at the Teen Pop magazine. This week is ruled by travel articles with Janani Anand's 6 crazy places to travel to, Tasnim Rizak's the top 5 best places to travel to in Europe, and Riddhi Bhattacharya's exciting account for traveling in Kenya. We also have 2 great poems, Nikita Makam's Terrifying Smells and Sounds and Sana Maria Bino's The Greedy Human Instinct. Riddhi Bhattacharya also continues her series with 2 interesting facts about period 6 elements, and Mikesha Harris talks about Hester Fine in her article, The Scarlet Letter. Alison Nagaran talks about scallop care, and Divya Patel lists 5 teen movies to watch from the 80s and 90s. Finally, teaching us some lifestyle is Belquis Sinsi in her article, Mental Health, The Key to a Better Life. Finally, we have the best article of the week, Handling Relationships, The Good Way, written by Dr. Kalyan Parime. Dr. Parime will now be joining us for a small chat. How are you, Dr. Parime?
I'm just doing fine. It's just a hectic day with work from home schedules.
Okay. Well, yes, being in such a situation, work from home is very stressful. Why do you think people find it hard to pull away from toxic relationships?
I would rather say it's like an addiction, more like an addiction or a guilty pleasure that you can mention it as. So people tend to be in that and they enjoy themselves. A part of them enjoy it. Most of them try to pull away, but you know, it's not quite possible because something that you love, it takes some time to leave those things, right? Or those humans. So what they do is they try to, you know, tell themselves that in a way that everything would be fine and soon the things would be at place. It's just either because of the situation or you know, things that led to a few other conclusions, and then a misunderstanding, a sort of misunderstanding that happens between people. But at the end of the day, you know, you cannot actually think of letting a person go, right? When you are into a deep, serious relationship. So
yeah,
that's when people find it hard to, you know, pull out of a relationship because they have invested their time, they have invested their efforts. So counting all of those things, people still tend to, you know, stick in one such toxic relationship until and unless something really, really, really goes bad, something worse happens. So they just wait till that happens and then they, you know, just shut their doors.
Well, thank you so much. That's a very clear picture and a good guidance that people who are in a toxic relationship could get. So you related a puppy and a chopper to a relationship. Can you explain why you chose those metaphors?
So a puppy and a chopper. So when it comes to a chopper, if you have to, you know, pilot a chopper, or if you have to pilot something that flies, you have to think of various things. So in case of chopper, it actually exerts a downforce in such a way so that it could go upside, like it could go upward. So if it has to go up in the sky, then he has to definitely exert some force, you know, towards the ground to get that lift. So basically this is something that happens quite a lot in a relationship. People exert a lot of force on the other person, or you know, they have a lot of expectations, which is nothing but a downside force that they exert just to, you know, lift up the relationship or just to get a sort of convenience, or you can say just a sort of a happy relationship. So that's when I actually related how a chopper can be related to a relationship. As coming to a puppy, you know that when you adopt a puppy or when you get a puppy home, then you definitely have to nurture it a lot because it doesn't know how to eat. It doesn't have any timings to eat. It will just, you know, pee here and there basically. So when that happens, you have to, you know, train a puppy, or you have to, you know, look after it for some time until it gets to know its owner, or it, you know, it believes its owner that it's for its own good. So sometimes, you know, your relationship is just like how a puppy would behave. It doesn't know where to go. It doesn't know what to do. So you have to nurture it slowly. If you know, a puppy learns quickly, right? After, like, as they age, they learn quickly. But it is required that you train a puppy, you be strict on it, and sometimes you are allowed to be lenient with it, so that, you know, it doesn't take you in a bad sense, or it doesn't get scared of you. So something like that is quite relatable to a relationship. That's why I chose those metaphors in that article.
Now that you've given such a good reason, I think it's a perfect fit of the metaphors that you have chosen. Now, talking about your book, you have taken up a book about handling relationships. So in relation to that, what is the best relationship advice you have ever been given?
Okay, so I didn't receive many relationship advices, but the few that I received from my best buddies were just to, you know, keep this going. They just told me that, you know, when things would happen, things will happen. Just don't force upon things, or just don't force yourself to get into any sort of, you know, a relationship when you don't want to, or when you're just not feeling to. It's just not a thing that you buy from a shop, or it's just not a service that you get from, you know, sort of store. It's basically something that would be there with you until you die. So it's better than a life insurance cover, I would say. So that's why, you know, you have to be very perfect when you have to choose such thing, or when you have to get into a relationship. So.
Yes. So let's move on. Let's hop on to some fun and games with some never have I ever questions. So my first question is, have you been in a toxic relationship?
No, I've never been into any relationship though. So yeah.
Okay. Never have I ever met someone on a dating app.
I did meet few people, and now those people, like, we have calls on weekly basis and sometimes monthly basis, and they are quite hustlers. Like, they are quite multi-talented people that I met there. So yeah, I have met people there.
Okay. Never have I ever gotten a tattoo.
I would say I did, but it's not there anymore. Like, I had to just, you know, it got removed in an accident. So, yeah.
Okay. Never have I ever met a partner's parents.
Okay, so this question is rhetorical, because like, I've never been into a relationship. So I guess the answer would be anyway, no. So yeah, it's a no.
Never have I ever bought a dog.
I did adopt quite a few, but I never bought any such dog. Like, I have adopted multiple street dogs and dogs from people who were living abroad, or, you know, who were either traveling back to India or coming from India. So yeah, I have adopted quite a few.
Great. Thank you so much for joining us today, Dr. Parini. It was amazing talking to you. Now, in case you haven't, go check out our new theme song by Natik, which is even playing in the background, by the way. As you are checking out the theme song, check out the interviews with wildlife photographer Ali Abdul Rahim, poet and dancer Ibrahim Sheikh, and Indian national women's player Sneh Rana at theteenpop.com. Finally, if you wish to join us as a writer, interviewer, designer, or NGO who wishes to be a part of Grow with Teen Pop campaign, then check out our website at teenpop.com. And that's a wrap. Thank you for joining me. Stay tuned for the next episodes of The Canary, hosted by other fellow writers, and I will see you again in a month.